Hello, my name is Sarah Yeomans. I'm an archaeologist, and I have a master's degree in archaeology from the University of Sheffield in England, and a master's degree in art history from the University of Southern California. I'm doing my doctorate now, and my dissertation research is concerned with ancient Roman medical technology and medical cult, and the effect that epidemics and epidemic crises had on the Roman Empire, both in terms of their political and economic circumstances, as well as their religious lives. I work for a nonprofit organization in Washington, D.C., and we research what archaeological science is telling us about the biblical stories. I live in the United States now, but I lived in Rome, Italy for 6 years, where I taught Roman archaeology, history, and art history. And that experience was transformative in the sense that I had the opportunity to use the city and its monuments as my classroom. And I realized that nothing makes history come alive more than being able to experience these places for yourself. And in fact, it was an experience like this that led me to become an archaeologist in the first place. For me, fieldwork is one of the most rewarding and interesting parts of archaeology. It is a lot like detective work, I would imagine. You have this mystery, you have questions that you're asking and you don't have the answers to. And the answers to these questions have to literally be dug out of the ground. And every layer you go down, there's potential to learn more. There's potential to gather more data and answer these questions and solve these historical mysteries. One of the projects I've been involved in most recently is an ongoing excavation at a site called Bethsaida in northern Israel on the northern shore of the Sea of Galilee. That site is a lot of fun to work at because we have evidence of over 1,300 years of occupation at this point. So every layer you go down, it's like you're moving backwards in time, learning more and more about the even more distant past of that site. It's also an interesting site to work in terms of its modern context, because Bethsaida is located in the Golan Heights, which was a contested area between Israel and Syria during the 67 war. So we may be excavating a pot that's 1,000 years old, just a few feet away from a Syrian bunker.
Herod was very concerned about security. Herodium is a what we call a palace fortress. It was very important politically for places like this to be not just impressive but intimidating. With just a little imagination, it's easy to visualize how beautiful these places would have been, because what we're looking at now are the bones of the structure. So we're here now at a site within Bethsaida called the House of the Fishermen. We tend to name sites based on things that we find in them. We really have no idea if this house belonged to a fisherman, but here in this structure, a lot of fishing implements were found. So that's what its name is.
Their ancient culture is very different, was very different from our own. But what was intriguing to me, and what is still intriguing to me, is what we have in common. And the things that concern us, the things that we care about, situations that are an inherent part of any human life, they're the same today as they were 2,000 years ago. And one of the most interesting to me, one of the most universal challenges that humans face, is the concern with health.